establish the vision. What you going to do this year? What are your goals? What are your plans? Are you going to get a car this year, or are you going to go another year without a car? Are you going to get a house this year, or are you going to go another year living with somebody you really don't want to live with? What are your plans? Because you need vision. And without vision, the people perish.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You're going to die another year.
Come on.
You've already died 12, 13, and 14.
Come on.
And you're going to die another year. And going to look 2016. You're feeling the same way you're feeling before you go in 2014.
Come on.
I ain't trying to do that.
Me,
amen.
I'm not trying to live a repetitive failure.
Right.
I'm not trying to be a repetitive failure.
That's right.
Amen.
Y'all mad at me?
Say it again.
Come on. Teach.
I'm not trying to live a life that I continually not going no further than where I am.
Right.
I want a car.
On how?
Tired of driving that cutlass everywhere I go. I'm sick of it. Maybe I want to drive it. Don't get me wrong. I love my car. But that ain't no everyday car.
Right.
That car will be parked somewhere until it's time to bring it out.
Right.
On the Saturday.
Right.
Summertime.
Yeah.
On the beach.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying to you? So I want a car. So you know what I've been doing?
Been riding past the car. Looking what I'm doing. I go to the parking lot, take the man's car. No, I ain't going to buy nothing. I'm going to take his car.
Are you looking for something?
Yes, sir. I am looking for something. I done test drive the man's car and everything.
So are you really interested? I'm really interested. Well, you got $20. Looking at a $25,000, $30,000 car. I ain't got $20. I'm going to get some money from my wife to get some lunch when I leave here.
Yes, sir.
And now, I know you're laughing, but this is what you got to understand about me. I'm a visionary. And I don't let my present state hinder my vision.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I can be broke, but I'm going to look like I'm rich.
Yes, right.
I can be sick, but I'm going to try to walk like I'm healed.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Because I'm not going to let my present state determine where I'm going.
Right.
And the problem is, we're entangled. That scripture says, no man that war entangles himself with the care of this world.
Come on.
No. I go right up on the lot. I went on the Buick Lacrosse lot. I was dressed up too. I popped my old school around the corner. I didn't want them to see that.
They tried that.
Mm-hmm. So I walked up on the man. He had a gray one and a brown one LG one. He said, "How you doing?" I said, "I'm doing fine. I'm looking at this nice car. Do you have any blacks?" "No, sir, we don't have any blacks, but we can order them for you." I said, "Oh, yeah, you can order them for me? What else can you order in it?"
That's right.
I sat behind the desk. Look, I'm sitting behind the desk picking the colors I want. I'm building myself a car.
Go ahead now.
I got a dime. Damn, I ain't got no money there. I'm sitting there like I'm the richest man. You think, excuse me, sir, you think this brown leather would go good in this black car? It sure would, was Mr. Willis. reason I'm doing this is because I'm feeding my vision.
All right. Oh, I'm teaching somebody.
Yeah.
I'm feeding my vision. See, because watch this. Your vision, you're birthed with. I'm impregnated with vision.
Yes. Yes.
Woo!
Yes.
Hallelujah. I'm impregnated with vision. And watch this. I treat my vision like a child.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I don't let it starve. Feed my visionary now and then. I go buy me a brand new pair of Jordans out the mall. Now y'all, just for y'all, they ain't nothing. But to me, I don't just go buy stuff like that. I don't go buy no $100 shoes like that. I'm going to find a deal somewhere or something.
No, that's right.
But every now and then, I'm going to get up. And if I don't work hard enough, buy me some shoes out the mall. How much are they? 110. Who? Watch this. I'm showing you how I operate. But one day, I'm going to wear whatever I want to wear.
That's right. Amen.
So watch this. Watch this. That's the vision. The vision is, one day, I'm going to be able to afford whatever I want. So watch this. Today, I'm not going to deprive myself. I'm going to get these shoes to remind me that one day, I'm going to be able to get every Jordan I want again. And what I do is I feed my vision. You understand what I'm saying? I feed my vision pieces at a time. Watch this. I want you to watch this. Y'all know this scripture. Y'all know this scripture. I want you to see this. Don't turn here because y'all know it. 1 Samuel, the 3rd chapter and the 1st verse. Remember this? Remember this? I preached it. And the child Samuel ministered unto the Lord before Eli. How many of y'all remember me preaching that? Watch this. And the word of the Lord was precious in those days. Here it is. There was no open vision. So watch this. There was no vision that was open. I got a problem here in this church. Because our major reason for where we are is that my vision has to be open. The reason that God replaced Eli is because Eli closed the vision. Y'all ain't talking back to me. Cookie, the reason that God replaced Eli is because Eli was closing the vision. And whenever you have no vision, you have lost purpose.
That's right. That's right.
If you is as far as you're going to go, what purpose do you have?
All right.
If you've touched everybody that you're supposed to touch, where is your purpose
right.
now?
That's right.
Some of you living because there's purpose.
That's right.
That's still some other stuff for you to do.
That's right.
Still some other places for you to go.
That's right.